On the January 2, 492, the last Muslim kingdom of Al Andalus fell to the Catholic monarchs Ferdinand and Isabella, putting an end to 400 years of the glorious Islamic civilization and upsetting in the era of the intolerance and persecution and the bloodshed which lasts to this day. As the last Muslim ruler of the Granada, Muhammad XII, the look back at the Alhambra Palace on his way into exile, he sighed and perhaps even shed a tear on seeing this formidable mother mock him. "Why do you cry like a woman for what you could not defend like a man?" Boabdil's abject farewell, the book ended one of the most glorious periods in Islamic and the European history. The Muslim peasants in the Iberian Peninsula, when the glorious tolerance and sophisticated scholarship, glorious architects, and the superior lifestyle prevailed. But the fall of the Granada also rehearted an era of colonialism, the genocide, brutal intolerance and persecution, with Muslim and Jews suffering the consequence, and this intolerance of other still serve as the blueprint for the Europe's interaction with Muslim at home and abroad. The glories of Al-Andalus. The Muslim army first entered the Iberian Peninsula in 711, at a time when Spain and Portugal did not exist as a nation. Rather, the territory was controlled by Christian Visigoths and pagans who were divided among themselves because of the Muslim advantage would be light and quick, and within a decade they could be campaigning deep into France. Muslim Spain is now best known by the glories of its architects and such as the Alhambra Palace in Granada or Grand Mosque of the Cordoba, both among Europe's most visited. The monument, it was perhaps the Cordoba Caliph which personified Al-Andalus at its height. During this time, the Cordoba became an unparalleled center of the mutual coexistence and learning when the master of the rest of the Europe was still in the Dark Ages. It truly was a place where the East met West, with Muslims, Jews and Christians all intermingling and all flourishing under Muslim rule. The Grand Mosque of the Cordoba, with its 400 marble, the Archer or Cordoba Library, where the wonder to behold. The latter include the manuscript from the ancient Greek and the Rome, which had been translated into Arabic, Hebrew and Latin. This document would stimulate the scholarship in the rest of the Europe, leading to the Renaissance. The zenith of the Muslim and the Jewish scholarship, such as the philosopher and the polymath Ibn Rushd, the astronomer and philosopher and Torah scholar Musi Mandoris, were the citizen of the Cordoba. The use of the deodorant and the toothpaste was the common place, where it was upheld of elsewhere. The tablecloth were used when dining, and Cordobians even invade the three courses of the meals. The Cordoba eventually became the largest city in the world, with a population over 1 million. It had the 400 school, 3,000 mosque and 3,000 inns, and 1 lakh the shop, and 19 public baths at a time when the Sars comment bathing. A few centuries later, Queen Isabella of the Castile would boast that he had only bathed twice in his life, once after the being born and once before her marriage. The Christian reconcessed the bath. If the truth be told, to the Christian reconcessed of the Iberian Peninsula start very soon after the arrival of the Muslim, when, though it would take 400 years to complete, by 15th century the Christian had begun to sequoia the Muslim so much that the few Muslim rulers who remained were effective vessels paying the last tribute in order to the step of invasion. The real impetus for the fall of the Granada start in 469, when the Ferdinand of Aragon and the Isabella of the Castile married to the united to the largest Christian kingdom. The Catholic monarchs, as they were known, were backed by the papal troops and the money. These monarchs, who are celebrated in Spain today as effective founder of the country, had a vision of the uniquely Catholic nation, and this basically meant killing, expelling and enslaving the forcefully converting the peninsula Muslim and the Jews. The size of the Granada itself last 8 months, with the Muslim completely surrounded and the outgunned. After the pleas for the help from the Muslim in the North Africa fell on deaf ears, and a result was the foregone conclusion. In the end of the Bawa Bill sign of surrender negotiation, which stipulated that he and his court had to leave by January 2, 492, the last Muslim ruler of the Andalus would spend the rest of his life in exile in Morocco. Sadly, the fall of the Granada would have devastating consequences for the peninsula's Jews and the Muslim. Around the 1 lakh Muslim were subsequently killed or enslaved, and 2 lakh fled, while the 2 lakh remained. The later a decree would be ordered, the forcing those who remained to convert to the Christianity on the pain of the death. The Catholic monarchs also passed a decree expelling all the Jews or forcing them to convert again on the pain of the death. The many Jews would seek refuge in the North Africa and the Ottoman Empire, where they would live peacefully with the Muslim. The Ottoman Sultan Bayezid II even sent his ship to Spain to save and reparated them. Aside from the physical extermination, the Catholic monarchs would also sanction the cultural vandalism. The previous Arabic and the Hebrew texts were banned, and Muslim the masterpiece such as Alhambra Palace and the Grand Mosque of the Cordoba was desecrated. The upon seeing the cathedral implant in the middle of the Cordoba Mosque, horrified the Charles I of the Spain, the remark, "They have taken something unique in the world and destroy it to turn into the something you can find in any city." The meanwhile, the Ferdinand and the Isabella would go down to the sponsor the Christopher Columbus to voyage to the New World in a bid to find a new trade route, which would the compensated for the Hague debate they had the accused in procuring the war. Their blueprint for how to deal with the minority became the model for many other European states as well, namely the extermination and expulsion, the forced conversion.